Good evening, everyone. It's Mark from Ford Mustang 98 Guy. Today's in-depth review, we are going to take a full in-depth walk-around look at the 1998 Plymouth Voyager Expresso. Today, I'm going to give you all a full and in-depth tour and walk-around of the van. I'm going to start it up. I'm also going to show the engine, and I'm also going to walk around the outside, and I'm also going to review the inside as well. I really do apologize. It's been a long time since I've made a video. Just been really busy with life. Really do apologize about that. It's been a while since I've made a video, but anyways, I'm back. Anyway, without further ado, let's sit inside. We'll start it up, let it run. There's the key fob. As you can see, it's in very good shape. It's the Expresso. As you can see, this one's in very great shape. It's actually, as you can tell, the paint's in excellent condition. Color of the exterior is dark purple. With light gray cloth interior. Interior is in mint condition as well. Just gonna make sure this is all the way back. Anyways, I think, yeah, it's all the way back. It's got 113,000 kilometers on it. Which is really nothing for a 1998. The owner has had it since 2000. It's a 98 model. And as you can see, it's in very good shape. As you can see, like, it's clean. I mean, inside and out. Once I start walking around, you'll see what I mean. So in the meantime, we'll take the key and we'll start it up. Starts right up. Then roll down the window. As you can see, also the steering wheel is also in good shape as well. It's very easy to steer. Horn works. I'm sure the horn works. So coming to your transmission, you have a 4-speed automatic transmission. It is a column-mounted shifter. What's very nice about these older Chryslers is that the gear shifter is really smooth, as you can see. Not bad. The parking brake is located down there with the brake release. As you can see, it's on. And I also forgot to mention up there, you also have warning lights that appear there as well. So in the meantime, we'll turn on the hazards. And we'll turn on the headlights. And the gauges do lit up green at night. Now, I'm going to walk around the outside, and you'll see what I mean. This thing's in excellent shape. It's rust-free, accident-free. I mean, look at it. It's like a 98 again. But the paint on this thing's in excellent shape. I mean, it's not even rusty or anything. There's no scratch. This thing's been looked after. I mean, as you can see. Look how good a shape it's in. I mean, this thing is clean inside and out. These are riding on Michelin tires, and these are aftermarket rims. See if I can get to the back of the van. That's the best I can do. Let's pop the hood. This thing was bought from Colombo. I think so. That's where, I guess, where it came from. Show the engine. It's a 3.3 liter V6. It's got an AC Delco battery in it. And there's the information. This thing's been looked after. I mean, look, I mean, the engine runs great. This is where the air filter goes. I'll close the hood. You have your power windows, power door locks, your door handle, fully manual driver's seat with manual incline. Your power mirrors are located off to this side right here. It does have a tilt steering wheel as well. All right, so now, in the meantime, let's review the inside. Roll up the window. Climate control. Different zones with your front defrost. You have air conditioning, recirculation. Let's see if the air works. Temperature. This is for the rear wiper. I'm sure it works. Yeah, it does. It does work. And you have your rear defrost. Not bad. It's got a AM/FM radio with CD and cassette player. This is the factory stereo from Chrysler.
Yeah. pretty enough, you're too dark, you're too short, you're on the wrong side of 25. You know, these were things that were said to me by people.
Precess stations?
How do you respond to things like this? You know what? Initially, I made the mistake of letting that
air vents
to me. And here I
was. Your power outlet right there. Cup holders.
And now I was letting this negative
storage down there.
I didn't know what to do.
Yeah, this is your armrest. Same with the passenger side.
And I was at a loss. You know, I lost my dad, and now I'm getting these
manually dimming rearview mirror
comments, and it's enough to really paralyze you into inaction and not to do anything because
the light still works, as you can see, mirror and vanity light.
And for many, and for a long time, I just
and you also have this also.
I think when you're in the yard,
slides out as well.
And there's a lot of negative speak. A lot of folks sometimes take that to heart.
Now to this side.
Look at that and
you have your
keep going.
You have your wipers and
so
turn signals.
I decided, you know what, enough is enough. I'm not gonna let random strangers or people tell me what my destiny is and what I can.
As you see, they work.
So I had to mentally.
Your wipers are right here.
I wish someone had told me this when I was 15.
Low speed.
A little bit different, or I would have gone
and high speed.
A lot of this stress and anxiety and worry about, you know,
not
doing
bad.
Right. Or
cruise control,
you know, a certain way.
Like I said, this thing has 113,000 kilometers on it, and coming out to your swimming cluster, you have your
really
engine temperature gauge, tachometer,
and
speedometer, and a gas gauge. And don't forget your gear selector.
It's a day-to-day challenge to do that, because when you put yourself out there, you're opening up to
and
a lot.
Like I said in the beginning about the gear shifter, it's very easy to shift.
And
the air is blowing ice cold.
And I've learned that trusting my instincts
pretty good.
Is the thing that I now.
And you have interior lights up here.
That was Rowena in conversation with Nana, but Duncan, take a listen to a track from the latest album.
Okay. Let's turn that down a little bit. YouTube don't like that. I don't want to get a copyright strike. Alrighty, so shut that off. I'm getting kind of cold in here. In the meantime, I think that's pretty much about it for the inside. So, let's check out the back seat. I pretty much showed you the whole interior. There's nothing really much to see, but now let's get onto the back seat. Interior is mint as well, like I said. I have to leave it like that. Sit in the back for a sec. This is the back. You also have a light right there. Same there. I did review a 2000 Caravan about 5 years ago, similar to this, but this one here is actually in much better shape. Back a couple years ago, you guys remember that 2000 Dodge Caravan that was sitting in that driveway there, but the neighbors who own that no longer have it. But this one here, this is a 98, this one here is actually in much better shape. As you can see, like, look how clean it is. I mean, it's excellent. Just an excellent shape. Now I'll get you the rear hatch. Or the trunk. I mean, it's pretty clean back here. And you do have cup holders for the second row back seat. Also have cup holders there. And in here, you got some storage. And in there, more storage. I think it's a storage console, I'm not sure. And you got a jack as well. So this is where your jack would be. And you got a power outlet. Nifty. This one's the Expresso. It's in excellent shape. Right to the side. It's okay. Here's the other side. This thing's actually old as me. I was actually born in 98. Isn't that funny? This thing is also, this van is a 98 as well. You also have a fully manual passenger seat with manual recline. I'm just gonna fix it a little bit so we can see it better. Sit. You have your glove box. This one works too. Mirror and vanity light in the passenger side. Not bad. That's the farthest I can get the seat to get back. See how the radio sounds. Let's do a little sound test.
And that's it for this edition of Big City Small World. I'm Errol Nazareth. Our producer this week is Anissa Dari. And thanks to Adam Carter as well.
Not a bad looking van at all. I like finding these older vehicles. You know, they're just becoming so rare. You know, we're in the year 2017, and believe it or not, this thing is still on the road and it runs like a champ. Let me just put the wheel up a little bit. That looks better. All right. So, let's go ahead and shut her down. Now we're going to come to the conclusion part of the video. I'll roll the window up in a little bit. Or actually, never mind. Oh, yeah. I'll roll it back up after. Well, everyone, that comes to the conclusion. I hope you guys enjoyed the full in-depth tour and walk around of the 1998 Plymouth Voyager Expresso. Stay tuned for my next video. We'll see you next time. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm very sorry it's been a long time since I made a video. Like I said, I've just been really busy with life. But anyways, I'm going to try my best to get more videos done, hopefully soon. So anyways, I will see you all in the next video. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.